And now, from Hilo's Afuk Chinen Civic Auditorium, Jones Space Link of Hawaii presents the 1989 Hilo High School Commencement Exercises, brought to you in part by Fair Contracting, Waiakea Villas, JCC Credit Union, Big Island Jeep Eagle Mazda, Your Aloha Connection, SureSave Markets, and Volcano Country Club Restaurant.
The cords these graduates are wearing this evening represents various awards and honors. The red cord signifies the academic top 10 students of the graduating class. The gold cord represents an honor pin. A blue cord signifies a Viking award, and the white cord represents a senior service award. Notice in your program that some students are graduating with honors such as cum laude, magna cum laude, and summa cum laude. These awards are given to students who maintain a cumulative grade point average of 3.0 or higher throughout their 4 years at Hilo High and have completed a minimum of 22 credits, which includes 3 years of college prep math, 3 years of science, and 2 years of one foreign language. Thank you. The Hilo High Alumni Association has solicited the donation of flags, which will be a permanent part of the future Hilo High commencement exercises. The flags here we have here tonight are on loan from the Honorable Spark Matsunaga's office. The flags which he will be donating to us were flown over the Capitol today, June 2nd, 1989. They will be presented to Class Vice President David Park and Junior Class Vice President David Lee on June 5th, 1989 in Washington, D.C. They will be on their way with five other students from Hilo High on the People to People Student Ambassador Program to the Soviet Union. Boy Scout Troop 21 will now present the colors.
We'll be back with more of Hilo High School's 1989 commencement exercises after these messages.
Please join me in the flag pledge. I pledge allegiance
to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Scott Dean will now lead us in the national anthem and Hawaii Pono'i. Pastor Wayne Cordero from the New Hope Christian Fellowship Church will now give the invocation.
Well, I was debating whether to ask you to kneel or to sit while I pray. Just to show you a nice guy I am, why don't you be seated? Not the students. Sorry. It was a very foggy morning, and a very large battleship slowly cruised into the area. And the admiral's eyes were peering to see whether or not he could navigate this area when, in the distance, he saw a dim light. Fearing that there might be some collision of some kind, and due to the fact that this was before the days of radar, he quickly took out his megaphone and he yelled through the fog. And he said, "This is Admiral Johnson of the U.S. Navy. Alter your course 10 degrees south. I am coming through." And in the fog came back the sound of a man. And he said, "This is Seaman 4th Class Stevenson. You alter your course 10 degrees north." Well, that made the admiral very upset, and he cried back, "This is Admiral Jones. I said you alter your course 10 degrees south." Came back through the fog, "This is Seaman 4th Class Stevenson. You alter yours 10 degrees north." Finally, in anger, he said, "This is Admiral Johnson of the U.S. Navy. I command you to alter your course 10 degrees south. I am a battleship." And through the fog, he heard, "This is Seaman 4th Class Stevenson. You alter your course 10 degrees north. I am a lighthouse." To the students tonight, I'm going to pray for you because I know that God has placed lots of lighthouses on your path, not in your way, on your path. And in your zeal, you'll want to mow them over, but they instead give you direction and give you hope. The lighthouse of parents, the lighthouse of church, of counselors, of wisdom. And tonight I pray that not only have you gained knowledge, you will have also gained wisdom, because that will take you through all the courses of life and get you there safely. Would you bow your heads with me? Heavenly Father, this evening I pray that as these students have gained knowledge over the years, that they will, not necessarily from books, but from life and from you, that they will have gained wisdom. For it is wisdom that gives them the true application of the knowledge. And Lord, when they see lighthouses, in their zeal, they will not go to break them over and to bash through, but instead, they will understand the wisdom as to why those things are there. Lighthouses of conscience, of parents, of wisdom, of counselors. Help them, Lord, to then navigate their life with wisdom and with safety. With your blessings and in your name we pray. Amen.
Back to the Civic Auditorium in just a moment.
Before we begin this evening's commencement exercises, we'd like to introduce some special guests. With us here tonight are the Chairman of the Board of Education, Francis McMillan, and Vice Chairman William Waters. Graduates, Mr. McMillan, Mr. Waters, Dr. Alan Garson, Mrs. Barbara Yoshimura, Mrs. Donna Saiki, parents, alumni, faculty, and friends. The graduating class of 1989 welcomes you and honors your presence at the commencement exercises. Tonight, these graduates stand in the spotlight. It is a night of reflection, of looking back, to the past 4 years, which they have shared together. Remembering the good times, like winning homecoming. Remembering the teachers who shared their knowledge. Remembering the parents who provided the care and support. And remembering all the special friends who made life so much fun. Together, they have shared the memories. Memories which they will always bond them together. Yet tonight, they realize that they must make a new beginning, a time to say goodbye, a time to look towards the future and their dreams. To begin tonight's exercises, the class of 1989 would like to sing a song which has been a tradition at Hilo High commencement exercises, Gariyamas Igatar. The classes will be accompanied by the Hilo High Band under the direction of Mr. Paul Arceo and will be led by Andrew Arceo. Each year, the Hilo High Alumni Association presents an award to the salutatorian. To make the presentation tonight is Mr. Ken Machida, Vice President of the Hilo High Alumni Association. Mr. Machida.
This year, the Hilo High Alumni Association would like to present this year's Salutatorian Award to an individual who has achieved academic excellence in her 4 years at Hilo High School. We, the Hilo High Alumni Association, would like to congratulate this individual and wish her the best in her future endeavors. I am proud to present Class of 1989 Salutatorian Award recipient Kathy H. Kawasaki. And her proud parents, Mr. and Mrs. Toshiaki Kawasaki. Why don't you turn around and take a look?
Welcome, Mr. McMillan, Mr. Waters, Dr. Garson, Mrs. Yoshimura, Mrs. Saiki, honored guests, parents, friends, and fellow classmates. We've come so far since our childhood days, our class song reminds us. Do you remember when we were in preschool and we played with building blocks? Each block had a different letter and design on it. You, the members of our class, are like these individual building blocks, unique in ways, yet similar. When we first entered Hilo High School during our freshman year, we were individuals, separate and inexperienced. We represented the diverse blocks from Kaumana to Lanakila, Kyokaha to Wainaku, from Papaiko to Honomu. As time progressed, we slowly developed a common bond between our fellow classmates. Like putting building blocks together, we were constructing our own future. To the guidance of our teachers, parents, and friends, the foundation was laid. Class unity was in the making. The road to constructing our future was not a simple one. We encountered various obstacles. At the time, these may have seemed overwhelming, but with our perseverance and determination, we never lost sight of our goal to be a strong and cohesive class. Together, we worked to overcome these barriers. Like the constructing of building blocks, we tried different combinations of personalities, values, opinions, and commitment, but not always would they fit the way we wanted them to. At times, part of our structure would chip away or fall out of place. Nevertheless, we picked up the pieces and continued to rearrange the design again. Remember homecoming during our junior year when we encountered a few obstacles in our quest to be the number one class in the competition? We're not able to attain this goal, but instead, this made us more determined to learn from our experience and continue on our quest to better ourselves. As you know, this year, we achieved the title of number one class in the overall competition. We cannot forget the spectacular senior week in February. Remember the eating contest, the boiled eggs, peanut butter sandwiches, and tangerine juice running down our faces? To top everything off, we packed the auditorium and lined the aisles with the first annual Foxy Mama contest. We helped to build not only class, but school unity and Viking pride. Sugar and Katie Dextrous, you are gorgeous. Through the years, we have come to realize the importance of each and every individual in the class. Each person has made his own unique contribution to completing the task. Every piece is important to putting together a solid superstructure. We started out as new blocks, but as the years progressed, each block has received its share of weathering to the tears, the laughter, the lectures, the hugs. As individuals, we have developed maturity and character, and each of us has found a place in the framework. The blocks have come together to form a firm structure, ready to withstand any challenge. Now, we are ready to go out on our own, building our own futures. Though we have successfully created a unified graduating class of 1989, there is far more building to do in our individual lives. Each of us will become components of the larger structure of life. Friends and relatives, here stands before you the graduating class of 1989. As our class song goes, the best is yet to come. Yes. We've only just begun.
We'll continue with the 1989 Hilo High School commencement exercises after these messages.
To present this award, I would like to call upon Mr. Richard Onishi, President of the Hilo High Alumni Association. Mr. Onishi.
Before I make the presentation tonight, I would like to give a short message from the Alumni Association. To you, the graduates of the class of 1989, we, the Alumni Association of Hilo High School, congratulate you on your shining achievement. You have just opened the doors of new opportunities and experiences. As young adults, you look forward with hope and anticipation. But take a few minutes and reflect on your years at Hilo High School. Those memories will last forever. It is with these fond remembrances that the Hilo High School Alumni Association is founded. Again, on behalf of the over 30,000 graduates of Hilo High School, we congratulate you, the class of 1989, and welcome you as fellow graduates. And yes, tonight, together you shine. This year, we are honored in having co-valedictorians. I would like to present Shelly Horiuchi. She is the daughter of Kimichika and Gloria Horiuchi. The other student receiving the valedictorian award is Tasha Willard. Tasha is the daughter of Jean and Carolyn Nagal. Tonight, to make the presentation of the valedictorian medal to his only grandchild is Leon Willard, her grandfather.
Good evening, honored guests, graduates, and friends. As I sat and prepared this speech, I encountered many obstacles. Time was running out, and I didn't know what I was going to say. Hour after hour, I produced nothing. I wondered what the problem was. Why couldn't I get my thoughts down? Why don't I know what I want to say? Then it dawned on me that I didn't really know why I was giving this speech. I knew I had the honor of giving this valedictory speech and that I wanted to say something meaningful to my class. Yet, I did not know what I wanted to accomplish by giving tonight's speech. This is what I lacked, a goal. This was not the first time it has happened to me, and I'm sure it has happened to you before. Therefore, what I'm going to talk about tonight is the importance of goals. I'm sure you have all experienced that time when you're in the middle of practice, or halfway through an English paper, or when there were 4 hours left at work, when you stopped and thought in disgust, why am I here? What am I doing here? But you need only remember why you're there. That is, your goals. And suddenly, your laps at practice become shorter, your pen seems to write on its own, and your 4 hours of work become 4 hours of accomplishment. Goals are the key, and I say key, because they will unlock the best in you. They will open the door to your world and everything in it. Once the doors are open, all you need is a determination, drive, and hard work to step through this door and capture this world. But that's another speech. Goals. Many of you out there must be thinking, tell me something I don't know. Let's see a show of hands of how many of you agree that goals are important. Thank you. Now let me ask you another question. How many of you have ever felt frustrated and said, I'm not getting anywhere, or what's the use? I've done all I can, and haven't accomplished anything. How many of you ever felt this way? Thank you. Too many times this has happened to us, that we face failure before we even tried to succeed. A wise fortune cookie once said, if you don't know where you're going, you'll probably end up somewhere else. Now I hope if you gain anything from my talking to you tonight, it is this. We are very powerful beings, and even when all seems lost, if we constantly keep sight of our goals, we can never go astray. When I was hitting barrier after barrier while writing this speech, I was nearly ready to throw my arms up in submission until I looked around at my classmates and saw someone that gave me inspiration and lifted my spirits. And I would like to share this story with you tonight. There was once a young man in high school, like you and me, an outstanding scholar and a good friend to all. He also happened to be a great wrestler. Having listened to me tonight, he set a goal to be the best wrestler in his hometown. However, early in the season, he learned that he had a benign tumor that would prohibit his participation in wrestling competition, as any solid contact would break his jaw. For a moment, his dreams were shattered, but he knew he wanted to be champion. Keeping sight of this goal, he worked hard as ever to maintain top condition, despite his restricting condition. Day after day, he kept on practicing. Meet after meet went by, and all he could do was cheer on his teammates. He could not compete, doctor's orders. Finally, he said to his doctor, look, I have this goal. I want to be the best wrestler. When can I wrestle again? With only a few meets remaining in the season, the doctor said he could wrestle, but that he would be taking risks. Nevertheless, he capitalized on this opportunity, this chance, and wrestled. Finally, the championship came around, and he did as he set out to do, and became champion. Many of you know this champion wrestler and champion of goals is among our graduating class. None other than 3-time BIF wrestling champion, Joel Nakamoto. Joel succeeded because he set goals for himself and never lost sight of them. In the same way, we, the class of 1989, must set goals for ourselves to guide us through our lives as we enter the real world as adults tomorrow. Thank you.
Tonight, I'll be speaking to you about what it takes to be successful. Think of my message as the four legs needed for the table of success. Like a table is supported by four legs, our lives are also supported in four areas. And to have a successful life, all four of these need to be in balance. So what are these four areas? They are your intellectual, your physical, your social, and your spiritual area. The four legs of the table. And if any of them are missing, like a wobbly table with only three legs, your life's going to be unbalanced. The first area I'd like to tell you about is your intellectual side. It's so important that we never stop being learners. And just because we're graduating tonight from high school doesn't mean that we're graduating from learning. That's what life is all about. It's learning from books, learning from experience, learning from people. Even when you get older, you never want to stop learning. Benjamin Franklin was 81 years old when he signed the United States Constitution. 81. And Colonel Sanders of Kentucky Fried Chicken, he created his 11 herbs and spices recipe at 66. Even the painter Michelangelo didn't paint his masterpiece, the Sistine Chapel, until he was close to 90 years old, 88 to be exactly. You'll never come to a place where you stop learning, because once you do, you start dying. The second area, or the second leg of the table of success, is your physical area. It's how you come across to others and the impression that you make on them. What you look like on the outside is always going to be a reflection of what you're feeling on the inside. It's going to show in your face, whether you're smiling or frowning. It's reflected in the way you carry yourself, when you walk, when you speak. A beautiful Quaker lady once asked if she would reveal her beauty secret. Her answer was rather interesting. She said, "For my eyes, I use compassion. For my lips, truth. And for my hands, the lotion of gentleness. And for my figure, uprightness." It was her inner beauty of compassion and truth and gentleness and uprightness that made her lovely on the outside, not the other way around. What makes you beautiful or handsome isn't just outer appearances, but it's your inner character and your inner attitude. The third leg of the table is our social area. The kind of relationships we have with the people around us. Success is often defined by the accumulation of money and possessions you have. But let's take a look at that definition. Say I'm a billionaire, and I offer to give you anything you want. You want a Mercedes? I'll give you three of them. How about a house? Make it a castle. Anything you want, it's yours. I'll give it to you. There's only one catch. You have to live in your castle with all of these things on a deserted island all by yourself. And too many people sell their families and friends at the price of success. Sure, they might end up being successful financially, but without anyone to share that joy of success with, life is hollow and empty. What I'm trying to say is that to be successful, we have to realize that people and right relationships are far more valuable than any possession or achievement. And now the fourth, and final crucial element, the crucial leg of the table of success, is your spiritual area. And it's not anything mystical or freaky. I'm just talking about the importance of getting to know the one who created and designed you. I can't think of anyone who knows about cars as well as the person who makes and manufactures them. And I can't think of anyone who knows you and I better than the one who created us. The Bible says that God created us and that He created us in His image. Just like a car has its owner manual, so too God gave us His word, the Bible, as our own personal owner's manual. And when you get to know the one who designed you, you'll be able to realize your fullest potential. Because God's the one who knows you best in every single area. So there are four crucial areas in our life. Our intellect, our physical, our social, and our spiritual. They all go hand in hand. And if you're balanced in these four, like a table standing securely on four strong and solid legs, you won't collapse, and you'll be able to carry all the weight easily on those solid legs. Class, I know we're a special people, and I know we all want to be successful in this world that we live in, and I believe we can be, and we will be, when our lives are balanced. Thank you very much. It's such an honor to be here tonight and see all of you.
Back to Afuk Chinin Civic Auditorium in just a moment.
Shelly Horiuchi, President of the Class of 1989, will now give a President's message, and David Park, Vice President, will present the class gift. Accepting the class gift on behalf of the student government is the 1989-90 Student Body Government Secretary, Michelle Shiba. David and Shelly.
Although my term as class president is near its end, the wonderful memories and ties to the class of 1989 will last a lifetime. The years that I have served as president have indeed gone by too quickly. It's these magical moments that can only be experienced once in high school that we want to grasp in our hands and make them last forever. As with any other class, we experienced our share of victories, laughter, and fun. And although we endured many disappointments and sad times, there really wasn't anything we couldn't do. Aside from our letdowns, we always bounced back with even more energy and Viking pride than before to more than compensate for our little setbacks. This was evidenced by our successful senior week, victorious homecoming, and superb senior variety show, to name a few. What set us apart from all the rest, however, is that whatever we chose to do, we did it with pride, spirit, and most importantly, style. We were special because we always did things our way. Each year was a unique experience, and things only got better with each coming year. There were many times that we sparkled before, but now is a time. Our moment is here to shine. I would like to thank you all for your dedicated support throughout the years, and I congratulate you for all the many achievements you've made possible. I wish you all the best of luck in the future. As time rolls on and we go our own ways, always remember your days as a Viking and cherish those memories of Hilo High. Remember that the class of 1989 will forever be together and that we'll always be one. Thank you.
Traditionally, a graduating senior class presents a gift in the form of money, equipment, or artwork to their high school. It is their way of saying thank you to the many people who have helped them to reach their goal of a high school diploma. This year, the class of 1989 is no exception. We would like to present a very special gift to Hilo High. It's a gift created with care and love, with the help of family, friends, local businesses, alumni, and the members of the class of 1989. Last Saturday, with pick and shovel in hand, a landscape rock garden, which is located adjacent to Wainui Nui Avenue, was constructed with donations from Glover, Mukai Flowers, Fair Contracting, and families from the senior class. Parents of chairperson Keone Farias, class advisors, and seniors all had a part in the construction of this garden. It is with this commitment to continue loyalty to Hilo High that the class of 1989 presents to all of you our friendship garden in the hopes that it will provide beauty and tranquility in your lives.
Seniors, this is a special night, a night which marks the end of your 4 years at Hilo High School. It also marks a new beginning as you embark on a new path, whether it is college, military, or work. Yet, it is also a night of thanksgiving, a time for all of you to thank your parents, teachers, and friends who have helped you to reach this night. And it is a time for all of us who have shared in your lives to thank you for being a friend, to thank you as seniors for providing the guidance and support we needed in school, sports, and extracurricular activities, to thank you for challenging us as we too look forward to our own commencement exercises. Your class gift, the Friendship Garden, will forever remind us of each of you and memories we have all shared. The work you put into making the garden and the feelings of love and caring will continue to inspire us. Thank you very much for being a part of our lives.
We are proud and privileged to have with us this evening Dr. Alan Garson, District Superintendent of the Department of Education. He has been an educator in Hawaii for many years. As principal, he welcomed the class of 1989 as freshmen to Hilo High School. Dr. Garson has laid the foundation for this graduating class and has returned over the years to influence and challenge the graduates. We are honored to have Dr. Garson present the commencement address. Dr. Garson.
Thank you very much. Board Chairman McMillan, Vice Chairman Waters, teachers and administrators, parents, friends, and members of the class of 1989. Good evening, Vikings. You've grown a lot in the past 4 years. I think I still remember you as ninth graders, and you've grown a lot, and I'm very proud of you. I'm pleased to be with you this evening to share some thoughts, hopefully some words of advice. As you may well know, commencement speeches have several distinguishing characteristics. They talk about the future, a new beginning, the struggles of going through school, and the challenges ahead. One thing they all have in common, they tend to be long. Well, being a teacher at heart, wind me up, and I go for 45 or 50 minutes. Now, only kidding. Seniors, I want you to take a few minutes right now and express your appreciation to the very important people in your lives who have brought you this far and who are about to set you free. Would you seniors, and I know you need to stretch too, and you do before I get into my lengthy address, would you stand and give your parents an ovation at this time and stretch your legs at the same time? Come on, give your parents an and your teachers. Believe me, they suffered just as much, if not more, than you did through these 4 years. Thank you. My message to you tonight is twofold. Be yourself and make a difference. To be oneself does not mean to do as you please without consideration of others or to take unfair advantage. It means to be oneself as a human being, making the most of your abilities and opportunities to stand tall and erect for what you believe to be true and honorable, to fight prejudice and apathy, to treat others fairly and with respect, because those qualities will be returned to you many times over. When you are 70 or 80 years old, and I hope we make it that long, and near the end of your temporary existence here on this earth, will you be able to look back and say to yourself and to your family, I have made a difference in the lives of other people, and they are better off because of what I did or how I lived. There are many who want to be ordinary, to be like everyone else, to be part of the fashion fad or the in crowd. Yet I say, the mark of excellence is to dare to be different, to leave this world just a little better than the way you found it. Where would we be without a Thomas Edison or Orville and Wilbur Wright or any of thousands of people that we could all name? Don't be just average, be above average. Strive to excel in whatever skill or talent you have. Enrich all of our lives because you are here. Build something, paint something, discover, write. Write something new. That's the magic of being a human being, to do something and do it well. Because each of us is better than most others at something. You may know what that is already. And others of you, you may still be searching for the something that is your forte. Keep looking until you find it, and then make the most of it. Exploit your best qualities and overcome your deficiencies. There are thousands of examples all around you. Just look at the achievements of your alumni and your classmates. And Shelley talked about Joel. We didn't trade notes and feed on each other. We arrived at these things independently. But look at your parents and your relatives. Many of them are shining examples in some special area, whether it be music or art or business. Let me recall a few special examples from my career. When I first started teaching, I knew a young man who had lost the use of his legs from polio, a dreaded disease which has since been almost eradicated in our country. He was a year behind in school because of extensive hospitalizations. He walked with braces and crutches. When I first met him, he was a 10th grader with a giant will and withered legs. As swimming and water polo coach, I had a small office in a corner of the gymnastics equipment room where they stored the equipment. This young man would pile up the tumbling mats around the side horse, or pommel horse as it's called today. You know, the one that Kurt Thomas made famous. He would pull himself up with his arms and begin his routine, and time again he would fall. At first I would try to assist him, but he would wave me away and pull himself up. As a senior, he won the Southern California Championship in the side horse. The reason he didn't make the Olympic team was because he couldn't keep his toes together. Shelley talked about Joel. But time and time again, I have witnessed feats of will. Immigrant students coming to a strange country and not knowing the language, excelling in academics, winning athletic championships, spelling bees, science fairs. Two scrawny ninth graders who worked hard for 4 years and finished 1-2 in the state diving championships. A ninth grader who was so shy he would rather take an F on an oral report than stand up in front of his class. And as a senior, was not only team captain, but gave a speech before more than 300 people at an athletic banquet. We could go on, and I'm sure you can think of many more, both large and small. Not everyone has a handicap to overcome, at least not a visible one that is evident to others. But we all have our weaknesses, whether it be arrogance or lack of confidence, academic deficiencies, or lack of willpower. Each one of us must strive to be the best that we can be. If I do not strive for the best, I am condemned to settle for mediocrity, to be average. That is not for me, and I hope that is not for you. Let me adapt a quote from Dean Alfange, the creator of the Junior Achievement Program, of which many of you participate, I know. I do not choose to be a common man. It is my right to be uncommon, if I can. I seek opportunity to develop whatever talents that God gave me. I do not wish to be a kept citizen, humbled and dulled by having the state look after me. I want to take the calculated risk, to dream and to build, perhaps to fail, but to strive to succeed. Enjoy the benefits of your creations and face the world boldly and say, this I have done. Remember, we don't do it all alone. We do it with others. As Hilo High Vikings, you have maintained the spirit of Viking pride in the hallowed halls of Hilo High for the past 4 years. Students like Shelley, Tasha, Kathy, Melanie, and Jennifer have excelled and led your class academically. In athletics, you've been led by state champions Dan and Corey, as well as Timmy, Keone, Joel, Christina, and many others like Betty, Kim, David, Noel, Cord, and many, many more. The list goes on in leadership. You have been admitted to some of the finest colleges in this country, like Purdue, Notre Dame, Loyola, Whitworth, Washington University, University of San Francisco, as well as University of Hawaii and Chaminade. You will soon be going your separate ways, to work, to college, to your country's service. But don't forget your roots, your community, and your alma mater, for they help shape you and nurture you. Join your alumni association. Keep in touch with each other, for together you shine. Your parents, teachers, and administrators have provided you with the values and skills for success. Use them wisely and beneficially. Be for something, not against. Be for health, not just against drugs. Be for order, not just against crime. Be for justice, for ethics, and for positive changes in our society, not just against the establishment. Do not be discouraged by setbacks, for they can be your best learning experiences. Find your own identity and pursue it to the utmost. Make your own path to success. My heartiest, best wishes to each and every one of you for a successful and satisfying future. Mahalo, Vikings.
Thank you, Dr. Garson. To present the class of 1989 is Mrs. Donna Saiki, principal of Hilo High School. Mrs. Saiki.
Good evening, graduates, Board of Education Chairperson, Mr. McMillan, Vice Chair, Mr. Waters, Dr. Garson, our honored guests and parents. It is a real distinct honor for me to present this class of 89 with all of their accomplishments and honors on this evening as they cross the threshold from student to graduate. You are the 82nd class to graduate from Hilo High School, and the tradition of excellence and pride and self in school that have come to be expected from anyone graduating from Hilo High School have been exemplified by each and every one of you. You are Viking pride. In the history of Hilo High School, you will be known as a small class. You started off with 350 and you're graduating approximately 285. These have not been easy years to grow up in, but you and your parents are to be commended for the value that you've placed on education these 4 years and the real consistent hard work that it's taken to bring you to this point tonight. For each of you, tonight represents a personal triumph because no matter how much support you've had from home or school, it has had to be your own personal commitment that has to succeed that has brought you to this point tonight. Although together you have arrived at this destiny, this night of graduation, each of you has had to be responsible for living your own life and finding yourself. And a saying by William Jennings Bryan states it real eloquently, destiny is no matter of chance, it is a matter of choice. And it is not a thing to be waited for, it is a thing to be achieved. Guiding you and leading you in your quest to achieve have been your parents and teachers. And on your behalf, I thank them tonight. As students of Hilo High School, you have made choices and you have lived, and through your living brought recognition and glory to yourself, to your family and school. Members of your class have performed and starred in our Performing Arts Learning Center. They've gone on to state competitions and from the athletic fields and courts. Your artwork has been recognized. Your vocational industrial arts work have always kept Hilo High on the list of winners. Scholastically, you have brought Hilo High to second place in the math league, bested only by Kohala this year. In foreign language and speech, you have excelled, and you dominated the Sterling Scholar Awards for this island, and only Maui had more scholars per school than Hilo High School. The total amount awarded for scholarships and awards to this class so far to date is $49,550, and there are still several outstanding. In addition, financial aid for about 100 of you will bring the total amount, dollar amount, toward continuing education, a real sizable amount for this class. Your awards have included state awards such as the Young Achiever of the Year, Sterling Scholar, the Ellison Onizuka Memorial Award, the John A. Burns Scholarships. And at the regional level, you've won in the Elks competitions and in the Exchange Club. It has been a wondrous year for me watching as you have unveiled your personalities, your strengths, your likes, and your dislikes. You have been a wonderful class to have had as a first class of seniors at Hilo High. And I appreciate your patience, your persistence, and your honesty. Thank you for making this a special year. The real strength of your class and of Hilo High School lies in the acceptance of the individuality of each member, yet always exuding a feeling of ohana and caring. It's a very real feeling at Hilo High. This was especially evident for your class as I watched you this past week at your senior activities. When you all jumped in the pool at the senior rally, your spontaneous hugs and your giant hug that it ended up being was real genuine. At your class picnic, you behaved with class. And when I left the park, I left with a really good feeling and a real glad feeling that I had been a part of your life. And so it is with pride this evening that I recommend the Hilo High School class of 1989 to Mrs. Barbara Yoshimura, who is here representing the Department of Education and the State of Hawaii. Mrs. Yoshimura, these students have met or exceeded the requirements as set forth by the Board of Education and the Department of Education, and I certify that they are worthy recipients of the diplomas which indicate the accomplishment of these requirements. Congratulations.
Shelly Mie Horiuchi, Class President, Valedictorian, Honor Pin, Summa Cum Laude.
David Park, Senior Class Vice President, Viking Award, Cum Laude.
Loreen Manligas, Viking Award, Senior Class Secretary.
Cord Newman, Senior Class Treasurer, Viking Award, Cum Laude.
Betty Ota, Student Body Government President, Viking Award. Cheryl Anchetta, Student Body Government Vice President, Viking Award, Cum Laude. Kim S. Takazawa, Student Body Government Secretary, Top 10, Honor Pin, Magna Cum Laude. Tasha J. K. Willerts, Valedictorian. Kathy H. Kawasaki, Salutatorian, Top 10, Honor Pin, Summa Cum Laude. Melanie A. Arakaki, Senior Class Representative, Top 10, Honor Pin, Summa Cum Laude. Jennifer K. Oba, Top 10, Honor Pin, Summa Cum Laude. Noel M. Mimaki, Top 10, Honor Pin, Summa Cum Laude.
Joel Nakamoto, Top 10, Honor Pin, Summa Cum Laude.
Tara Connor, Magna Cum Laude. Janelle Ascension, Top 10, Magna Cum Laude. Lisa Faye Buza, Senior Class Representative, Viking Award, Cum Laude. Julie Gardner, Viking Award, Senior Class Representative, Cum Laude. Christina Henricks, Viking Award, Cum Laude.
Anthony Kawakami, Viking Award.
Karen Matsumura, Viking Award. Cindy Otsu, Senior Class Representative, Viking Award.
Andrew John Arceo, Senior Service.
Nyla Peterson, Senior Class Representative, Viking Award, cum laude.
Thomas Barnes, Senior Service.
Claire Sagawa, Viking Award.
Chad Keone Farias, Senior Service Award.
Marcia Seto, Viking Award.
Shane Gali, Senior Service Award, Magna Cum Laude.
Jody M. Wong, Viking Award.
Craig E. Kennett, Senior Service, Cum Laude.
Stacy M. Boley, Senior Service. Pam Oreo, Senior Class Representative, Senior Service. Karen K. Ikeda, Senior Service. Jennifer K. L. Iopa, Senior Service. Robin Kaneshiro, Senior Service, cum laude. Jody Nako, Senior Service. Christy M. Sunada, Senior Class Representative, Senior Service Award, cum laude. Nicolette Wihonko, Senior Service, cum laude.
Daniel Affleck.
Kimberly S. Akpun.
Terrence Ugliam.
Romlin M. Agudo, cum laude.
Dan Ahuna.
Lloydine Ani.
Brandon Allen.
Don N. Atum.
Timothy Amar.
Jennifer L. Ahia.
Gregory Awai.
Romy Alaniz. Luana L. Dedrick.
Fabrin C. Estrada.
Sarah C. Doudna.
Geronimo O. Felipe.
Mary Lou Dukuson.
Sean Ferreira, cum laude.
Tina Marie Enna.
Larry T. Fujimoto.
Jendi N. Estabilio.
Jonathan Gakutan.
Joyce Evangelista.
Wilson Galdones.
Cheryl Marie Guinness.
Curtis Masaki Gusukuma.
Michelle Gomes Figuera.
Roy K. Hailey.
Rosemary Garospi.
Neil Hessler.
Kathy Kaleolani Hall.
Jonas Haitala.
Jill S. Imaizumi.
John Hogan.
Gina D. Jamero.
Ark Ho'opi'i.
Juliet B. Jumilla.
Philip K. Kaho'one.
Maya A. Kondo, cum laude.
Clarence C. Kaipo.
Melissa Ilaniwai Kua.
Milton K. Kalai.
Celeste Ilima Kualii.
Samuel K. Kamahele.
Terry Lelani Kubo.
Eugene Kalahale Kapu Jr.
Wendy L. Labrie.
Ah! Dion Keller.
Joni Lenosa.
Stanley Kelly Colio.
Mikayla K. Lee.
Graydon K. Kelly.
Mona Lee.
Shane Kualii.
Tori Lealoha.
Morris Kuamo'o.
Jojan Layson.
Gilbert Kuheana.
Angela Lorenzo.
Edward Kukahiko.
Myra Majame.
David Lealoha.
Anna Maneha, cum laude.
Jason Leone.
Terry J. Martins.
Michael Liborio.
Charisse Masaki, cum laude.
William Maffitt.
Cynthia Matsui, magna cum laude.
Haoli Kamaka Mahoi.
Tina Matsumoto.
Wendell A.K. Manua.
Natalie K. Mina, senior class representative.
Victor Martin.
Jeanette Montenegro.
Brian Patele Maderas.
Chanel Nachor.
Marcus K. Mikami.
Judy Nakalon.
Alfred J. Nina.
April Mikiko Nakaji.
Chris D. Moniz.
Tisha Nakasato.
Jared Moniz.
June Nangayan.
Dale Morita.
Stacy Ohano.
Carling Bull Nabarro Jr.
Kelly Okano.
Dennis Nagao.
Shannon Oshiro.
Jason E. Napihaa.
Tara Overturf.
Timothy K. Nicholas.
Corina L. Pacheco.
Douglas A. Oki, cum laude.
Sherry Pacheco.
Ron Okubo.
Erica M. Pike.
Lyle Mickey Omoto.
Trina Parbo.
Richard L. Pabre.
Melissa Pereira.
Brian Paiva.
Francis Cheryl Polikapu.
Joseph Paiva.
Janet Ragasa.
Joe Pasqua.
Amelia Ranchez.
Vince Pereira.
Belinda Raquel.
Jesse S. Perez.
Monica C. Richardson.
Edward M. Pinzon.
Cheryl Royston.
Lopaka Pua.
Trisha Sagawa, cum laude.
Arnold Quivito.
Tammy Lee Sampson.
Clarence Rosehill.
Darcy Sanders.
Royden Sabate.
Jermaine Silva.
Anthony Santos.
Iris L. Solomon.
Jason W. Santos.
Jody Ray Souza.
Frank S. Sensano.
Leanne Spencer.
Mark T. Shigihara.
Mary Stevens.
Dean Osamu Shirota.
Lolita C. Tabellissima.
William Simao.
Marlene Tagaka.
Benjamin Arthur Sioloa.
Elisa Tohon.
Chris Steiner.
Serena Tavares.
Christopher Tangaro.
Wendy Tavares.
Chad Tim Singh.
Cheryl Sunizumi.
Michael Terrell.
Don T. Uchida, cum laude.
Jay Tolentino.
Leanne Urasaki, magna cum laude.
Brendan Y. Uchima.
Karen Vanetta.
Roger Uchima.
Selena Ann K. Victorino.
Michael Y. Une.
Leilani Q. Villanueva.
Eddie Oratani.
Uilani Janelle Viveros.
Kip Urban.
Christine I. Witkowski.
Lee K. Victorine.
Althea C. Gabbis.
Scott Paul Wyau.
Bonnie H. Urong.
Quincy W. Wyke. Dwayne K.K.H. Wipa. Delbert A. Whitney Jr. Edla Kalu Wilson. Stanford C. Wong. John F. Yamabe. Scott K. Yamamoto. Len Yoshihara. Shane Yoshida. Stanley L. Urong. Almar N. Zamora.
The 1989 Hilo High School commencement exercises continue in just a moment.
The lyrics are written by Melanie Arakaki, who, with the assistance of Jody Wong, has also arranged the music. The song represents the feelings of the graduates tonight as they reflect on the memories they have shared and look forward to their dreams of the future, knowing tonight is the last night they'll be together as a class of 1989. They present to you their class song, Together We Shine, led by Melanie Arakaki.
Tonight is my time, please shine.
Single Alma Mater, the graduating class would like to thank all of you for sharing this memorable occasion with them. Thank you for being a part of a very special night for the graduating seniors of the class of 1989. Just remember to all here tonight, please, if you drink, don't drive. Now the singing of the Alma Mater will be led by Charlene Chetta, accompanied by the Hilo High School Band.